In this video, we'll talk about advanced masking. We've already talked about masking in a previous module, and we used the line masking tool, which is great for creating split screens. But as always, we can take it to the next level with a bit of creativity. So let's jump right in. We'll be editing a scene in which I intend to clone myself to appear 6 times in the frame. I filmed this scene using a tripod to keep the frame the same for all the shots and walk through the scene stopping at different places. This stability is crucial when combining multiple shots into a single scene. And here's how we'll do it. First, we're gonna open CapCut and start a new project. Then we're gonna import our clip. Let's play it. And then you can see that there is me walking from the right upstairs until we arrive in this enter area. Then I stop, I look at the view, and then after a few seconds, I start walking downstairs this time on the opposite side. So we can recognize already 3 parts where I'll be able to clone myself, one on the left, one on the middle, one on the right. Then if I move forward in the clip, I'll be able to see that I basically go in the next level. I stop for a few seconds in the center, in the middle of the frame, and then I walk towards the left on the opposite side. So now we need to split this main clip and identify the positions that I want to mask. So the first one is gonna be when I go upstairs from the right until I reach this point right here. Then I'm gonna split right here. Then we can move forward until I move in the central area. Then I just look around, enjoy the view, there you go. And then I start walking towards the left. And then I can split right in this moment as well. Then again, I'm gonna walk towards the left and I can keep this part. Then we can split it again. Then we keep scrolling, keep scrolling, keep scrolling. And then we need to take from this part where I'm in the top right, basically, so next level. We're gonna split, select the beginning and delete it. Then we're gonna take this part right here. I'm walking in the top right of the screen, just right there, until I go behind the vase. There you go. So I'm gonna split it right there. And then I'm gonna move forward, move forward. I stop in the middle, that's it. Then I'm gonna start going out again. I'm gonna split right when I'm behind the vase. That's it. Then we got the last part of the clip where I'm moving again towards the left and disappear from the frame. Our job now is to create overlays for each of these parts and mask each part only in the section where I appear. So we're gonna take the second clip and then we're gonna scroll in the menu until we see overlay. There you go, here, and then we tap on overlay. Now we created a new track below the main track, below the main timeline, and we're gonna drag this clip towards the left. There you go. And now I can see that there is me in the middle, just looking around on top of everything else. But then we're gonna mask this one. So let's trim this clip first. There you go. And then we're gonna select this one underneath. We are gonna go in mask right here. And then we are gonna select rectangle. Boom. Now, as you can see, I already appeared on the right part of the screen because I'm just using this part where we masked the clip on top. Now we just need to adjust it to make sure that I don't go over any other part of the clip where I'm gonna be masked. So we're gonna be here. And with these arrows right here, I can modify the mask. I just make sure to be masking only myself in the middle right here. There you go. Just like that. Even smaller. Just literally here in the middle where I'm standing looking at the view. We're gonna tap on the check mark and then we're gonna scroll and see whether we like it or not. So I can see, for example, that at the beginning of the clip, I'm basically out of the masked area. So what I'm gonna do right now, I'm just gonna extend this clip a tiny bit and then I'm gonna delete the beginning instead, just like that. And now it should work perfectly. Let's see. Yes, that's perfect. So now let's keep going. So now let's proceed with the following clip. So we're gonna tap on it and then we're gonna scroll in the menu until we see overlay. Then you tap on overlay. So now we're gonna drag this one on top of all the other ones. There you go. But you'll notice that there is also me walking downstairs in the bottom left. This is because maybe the layer that we put on top is not actually on top, but we can check this by scrolling in the menu and tap on layer. There you go. You see that now is on the second level, but if we put it on the third one, then we'll have it on the very top layer. That's why now I disappeared from the bottom left of the frame. We're gonna tap on the check mark and let's create a mask on this one so that we'll be able to reveal all the three me underneath. We're gonna go into mask and then again, we're gonna pick rectangle and we're gonna position the rectangle just right here. And I think we should be good to go like that. Let's double check. There's only one problem right now. I can see that there is a patch right there. This is because the moment where I was in the upper level changed in time and the clouds and the colors of the sky changed. So now we need to apply some feather in order to blend it better with the bottom layers. We're gonna go into mask. And then we'll be able to adjust the feather by dragging up or down this icon right here. So we're gonna drag it down just a tiny bit. And then I think we'll have to adjust the rectangle as well, just like that. And now I'm good. If you want to be more precise by creating the feather, you can tap again on the master you created here on adjust. And then you can go in feather. Then we just need to adjust the feather by moving it towards the left. And now we should be good to go. And then we move on with the following clip right here. We're gonna tap on it and then we're gonna put it as an overlay again. Then we're gonna drag on top of everything right here, just like that. Then we're gonna position it towards the left. We make sure to take only the part where I'm in the middle. So right here, split, delete the beginning and then drag it again at the very beginning of the sequence, just like that. That's perfect. Then we can remove this part. And now we're gonna create a mask again on top of this one. So we're gonna go into mask. And even here, we'll have to be extremely precise while creating the mask. So we're just gonna make it as big as me and no bigger than that. And if you want to be even more precise, you can just go in adjust and then we'll be able to move the position. There you go. Just like this. Then if I wanna decrease the size, I can do this. And we try to be as precise as possible. And this looks great to me. We're gonna tap on the check mark again. At the moment, there is five of me. We can add one more. Oh, that's lovely. Six of me in the same frame. Now that we finished this sequence, there is one more thing that I want to show you. Now let's export this sequence. You're gonna tap again on the export button. We're gonna select 4K and then we're gonna save to device. Then we're gonna click on done and we're gonna create a new project and we're gonna import the one that we just exported, which is the last one. We're gonna add to the project. Now what I wanna do, because this sequence is really cool, but is a little bit short. I would like to have it a little bit longer, but because these clips were not shot in slow motion, I couldn't really make it longer. I don't have enough frames. But there is a very cool feature in CapCut that allows you to make your footage shot normally at normal speed in slow motion. Let's select this clip now in this new project, and then we're gonna go in speed. Here we're gonna tap on normal, and then you'll be able to modify the speed. Let's say we're gonna put it at 0.5 seconds, like that. So we'll be able to transform our 5.5 second sequence into an 11.1 second sequence. So now if we play back this sequence, you can see that it's lagging quite a lot. Because again, this footage was not shot in slow motion. But then what happens is we can tap on this menu and then we can select better quality or faster process. We're gonna select better quality. This will allow us to slow down our footage even if it wasn't shot in slow motion. So let's tap on the check mark right now. And then we're gonna wait until CapCut applies this slow motion effect to our footage. Now the slow motion has been applied, I just want to do two things. First of all, I want to mute this clip. So we're gonna tap on mute at the beginning of the timeline, and then I want to add an epic music in the background. So we're gonna tap on audio, we're gonna go on sounds, and here we're gonna search for epic. Okay, I think I like this one, so I'm just gonna add it to the project. Awesome, we just need to cut the music here, split, delete. Let's review our final result. This is just one example of what you can create with masking. This process may require some trial and error, so don't worry if it doesn't look perfect on your first try. Common challenges might include aligning the clips correctly or getting the feathering just right to make the overlays look natural and seamless. So as you can see, there is no limit to what we can create if we start thinking outside the box. And these advanced masking techniques allow us to create impossible scenes that can add even more interest to our edits. Remember, with each new skill you master, your storytelling abilities grow. So keep pushing the boundaries, keep experimenting with these tools, and most importantly, have fun with your creations. Happy editing, and I'm gonna see you in the next video. This video gave you a sneak peek into what our iPhone Video Editing Academy has in store. Delve deeper into mastering advanced video editing techniques, from initial cuts in the Photos app to creating sophisticated scenes in CapCut. Whether you are a beginner or looking to up your video editing game, this course equips you with everything you need to make your project stand out. Join me as we explore the art of video editing, ensuring your content captures the essence of your creativity. Are you ready to elevate your editing skills? Check out the full course through the link in the description. I'll see you there.